Good evening. I know we've got about two more minutes, but we'll go ahead and let them come on in the room. We've got about two more minutes, so we'll go ahead and let them come on in the room. Yes, it's about that time. Yes, Lord, it's about that time. It's Wednesday Rap Word. We're going to allow them to come on into the room as we prepare to study, to show ourselves approved unto God tonight. And we're just so grateful that God has blessed us, and we're just grateful. Yes, we're early, but I want them to have an opportunity to come on into the room where there is blessings that are going on in the room. Amen, amen. And we want, as they come into the room tonight, that they come prepared to be blessed. They come prepared to do what only God can do, and that is to do the miraculous work. Amen. So we're just gonna play a little song, a little prayer, praise, and as they come in, good evening, Sister Edwards. Good evening, Sister Brown. Good evening, good evening. We're just gonna play a little something.
Lord, I wanna thank you. That last night, my baby,
somebody else can relate to this prayer today. Thank you, God.
Oh, God, I just want to take a minute to tell you thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord.
Ah, bless the
thank
Lord.
Thank you that you kept me when I didn't know how to keep myself.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
I thank you that you never left me and you've been with me every step of the way.
We're allowing them a chance,
Lord,
to come on in.
Nobody else brought a Thanksgiving in their
hearts. Some of you may have heard this prayer before.
I just want to tell you, much obliged,
sir.
I'm so grateful. I'm grateful for every day that you brought me out. I'm grateful for every moment that you wrapped your loving arms around
me. I wonder if I got some
grateful
folks on tonight.
Time you regulated
me and kept me in my right mind. I'm grateful.
I'm grateful. I'm grateful.
Thank you, God.
I'm grateful.
Thank you, God.
Lord, I'm so grateful.
Thank you, God.
I just want to tell you thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for food on my table.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for clothes on my back.
I just feel
thank
like thanking him tonight.
This morning,
I just feel like thanking him.
Over my head.
Right, you're in the right place. You're in the right place.
I remember.
Thank you, God.
I remember how we used to say.
Thank you, God.
I woke up this morning with my mind, and it was stayed on Jesus.
Come on. Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
I don't need. I don't need no rocks crying out in my place.
Ooh.
But Lord, you've been so good to me.
Yes, you have.
I cannot tell it all.
You ought to go and tell somebody they're going to have some Bible word tonight. Come on, you ought to go ahead and tell them it's starting up on fire tonight. Thank you
for being my burden bearer.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
Please, please, please. Please excuse me while I check off my list.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for keeping me.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for shielding me. Thank you for protecting me. Thank you for bringing me.
I know I got some full set of praise tonight. I know, I know.
Thank you for saving me.
Thank you, God.
Thank you for raising me up, God. Thank you, thank you, thank you, sir. Thank you, thank you, thank you, sir. Thank you, Jesus.
That's right, Jesus. Just plug the line. Just tell him thank you. Yes, he has.
You've been my rock in the weary land.
Yes, he has.
Lord, you've been my shelter in the time of storm. Lord, you've been my way maker. You've been my rock. You've been my redeemer. You've been my strong tower. You've been my everything.
Yes, God.
Lord, thank you, thank you, thank you.
God, I thank you. God, I thank you. God,
Lord,
I thank
I just
you.
Came to ask you to have mercy on us. I just need you to stop by the sanctuary today. and touch those who are sick in their body.
Yeah, God.
Touch the man, the woman, the boy, or the girl that came in with
confusion or emotional depression. Thank you, God.
Lift them up and restore unto them the joy of their salvation. Lord, I just want to take a minute and make our request known. We need the Holy Ghost to make himself visible in this house. Send a glory cloud that sets down on every...
Good Wednesday evening, my brothers and my sisters. God is good, and we are so thankful that God has allowed us to come together one more time. I am the Reverend Dr. Arthur Holmes, the pastor of Holy Trinity Amy Church, located at 378 Mathis Ferry Road, where the Spirit of the Lord is truly in control, and we are trying every day of our lives to make disciples of those whom he has called to do his work. We greet you in the name of our matchless Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who has been so kind and so good to us and been so marvelous in his work, so wonderful in his doing. And we've come on a Wednesday night just to study and just to see what the Lord has for us to do. And we're just grateful tonight. I just had that all the way coming home and preparing myself, because it's been one of those days where I've been going from here, there, a little bit of everywhere. I just had that in my spirit all day long. And I've just been meditating on that prayer, just asking God to do what God can do. And I want you to go ahead and invite somebody. It's 6:34 on this Wednesday evening. And would you believe it is June the 9th? My God, it is June the 9th. And the Lord has allowed us to just be in this presence, in this place where we can come and bless each other, because you're allowing me to prepare for the teaching also blesses me at the same time. And so we're just so grateful for those of you who are coming on. We want you to go ahead and those who are on the teleconference, we thank you so much. And we just bless God today for all the miraculous things that God is doing, even behind the scenes. And we just ask that you continue to lift up our church, once again. The death angel has visited, and we just say to the Alston family today, may the peace of God and the grace of God be with you. And we're just knowing that God's going to take you through this, and God's going to keep you covered under the blood. Good to see you, Licentia Taylor. Good to see you, Reverend Parker. We're just so grateful for how good God is and how good God continues to be in our lives. And I don't know about you, but every now and then, before we get into our word tonight, because we won't be before you long tonight, because the Lord's not giving me the longness tonight. He's just giving me a longing. Amen. Not length, but he's just giving me a depth of desire. And we're just grateful tonight. But as we go, I just want to play just a little bit of this as we come to ask God to bless us tonight. I believe, and I've lived long enough, that you've got to get the atmosphere right, even for teaching. Because if the atmosphere is not right for teaching, then the atmosphere will not be right for receiving. And so we just want just a little bit of this, and we're going to go into what we have planned for you tonight.
Oh, my soul. And all that is
that's an old school praise and worship.
Blessed be the Lord.
Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord.
Sing from your spirit. Sing from your spirit.
Come on, come on.
You are the
bless the Lord.
Oh my soul,
oh my soul,
and all that is free,
yeah. Tonight's gonna be a little different. Tonight's gonna be a little different.
God, we sang it out love. I wish somebody
would
remember that old school. Bless your name.
Bless your God. Bless your God.
We sing from your spirit. From your spirit.
Come on. Bless. That's like a dewy step. That's
smell a dewy smell. Thank you, Lord.
Let us pray. Turn to God, our Father, the creator of all good and perfect gifts. God, move Arthur out of the way and allow your man of God to do what you have called him to do for this evening. God, bless those who've joined on and bless those who may be joining. God, we just thank you in advance for what you're going to do. It is in Jesus' name. God, let the words of my mouth and meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. We continue to lift those persons up and prayer. Good to see Lady Holmes on with us tonight. And in since we're Taylor, you ask whose version was that? That's the Reverend Dr. E. Dewey Smith, one of those great preachers. Amen. The pastor of the House of Hope. We're grateful. Tonight, I want us to look at just one passage of scripture. Good evening, my sister Annie. I wonder when you were coming on. I want us to look at one passage of scripture tonight. One passage of scripture. And we're going to just dissect just those words, and we're going to leave with a better understanding. I want us to go to the Old Testament tonight. We're going to look in the book of Micah. Micah chapter 6. Amen. Micah chapter 6. And go ahead. That's right. Somebody else, let somebody else know. Go ahead. We lift those persons up, as we said earlier, in prayer, as you find Micah chapter 6. Amen. Micah chapter 6. And we're just going to look at verse 8 tonight. Micah chapter 6, verse 8. That's all we're going to talk about tonight. And once we have done what thus says the Lord, we're going to move right on out of your way. Amen. Micah chapter 6, verse 8. That's all we're going to talk about tonight. But it's going to leave us, hopefully, thinking about that which we are required to do. And so many times when we get jobs and we get responsibilities, our first question is, what is the responsibility? What am I supposed to do now that I have been hired in this position? God bless you. God bless you tonight. And we just want you to have a better understanding. But Micah chapter 6 and verse 8. Thank you, tech team. Micah chapter 6, verse 8. The New Living Translation says, no. And let me give you some background. This is when they were having a conversation. What does the Lord ask of us? Should we give our firstborn as a sacrifice? Do we still need to bring that offering before him? Do we still need to kill the fattest calf or the best calf that we have or the best animal that we have? And do we still need to bring it to the Lord? And here we find in Micah chapter 6 and verse 8, it says, no, O people, the Lord has told you what is good. Now, I want you to understand something. Notice in this book of Micah, it is not saying, I am telling you what is good. It is not, I'm reminding you what is good, but it says, the Lord has told you what is good. And as believers of God, as children of God, we've got to, first of all, let me say this to you. You've got to know who's speaking to you. Okay? Because a lot of time, the voice that you hear is not the voice of God. We've got to understand that the sheep has to know the shepherd's voice. The sheep has to know the shepherd's voice. And in order for you to know the shepherd's voice, you got to spend time with him. You got to lay yourself before him in a prostrate manner. And you got to ask the Lord, what more can I do? Because even our best are just like filthy rags in his sight. So we've got to remember that we've got to constantly humble ourselves and do what is asked of us. So the first thing he asks, first thing I want you to know, you got to know who's speaking to you, okay? Because a lot of times, and I know this with people on the phone, if I don't have their number saved in my phone, and they'll call and they'll start talking, and then I'll say, okay, keep talking. You don't know who this is? No, keep talking. And then something at some point will click, and I'll know exactly who I'm talking with. So first of all, the Lord has told you what is good. So there's no excuse tonight. There's no excuse for those of us who are born again, for those of us who have a relationship with the Lord. And there's no excuse for those of us who have a relationship with the Lord. Come on now, because in order to have a relationship, you should be striving every day for that relationship to get stronger and more sincere. Amen. Sister Holmes and I, we tease each other every now and then that she can start a sentence and I'll finish it. And I have to tell her, okay, get out of my mouth. In other words, the relationship over the years, we began to think alike and we began to be able to complete each other's sentences. And so you've got to know what the Lord not only can do for you, but you got to know what he sounds like. He says, and this is what he requires of you. Micah 6:8. And this is what he requires of you, to do what is right. And your version may say justly, but to do that which is right. Don't you know that it's right to do right? We've got to understand that as children of God, we are no longer in control of ourselves when God takes over. We've got to understand, Pastor, what do you mean? What do you mean I'm not in control of myself? Because your thoughts are not his thoughts. But I guarantee you this, when the Lord comes into your heart, when the Lord saves you, when the Lord enters salvation into your life, you will then start realizing that your thoughts are no longer the way they once were. The things that once got you excited, the things that, and folks think I'm crazy because I get excited about the Word of God, but that's because the more I read, the more I learn about my Father, the more I love about him, the more I want to learn more about him, the more I want to know what he requires of me, because I want to do what pleases God. So we have to do that which is right. And the time to do that which is right now. Pastor, what is right? Well, we got to learn to love our neighbors as we love ourselves. And so that's why it's important that you learn to love yourself. Instead of finding all the wrong things about yourself, for every wrong thing you can find, guess what? I'm quite sure if you were looking in a positive vibe, you'll find 3 positive things. But so many times we look for the negatives. We look for things to have pity parties. We look for things to be able to bring us down and things to just tear us apart. But no, what he's saying tonight, do what is right. Okay, we've got to learn. I don't let what people do to you becomes an excuse for you to mistreat other people. Because all of us needs to understand that as a man soweth, he's going to reap. And let me put a little pin. What goes around comes around. And it's just right to do right. And you will not find everybody who will treat you the way you treat them. But guess what? That does not negate your responsibility as a child of God to do the right thing. Everybody else on your job may be doing the wrong thing, but that does not negate you to do the right thing. Everybody, you cannot, and I'm talking to myself and it sounds like you now, but I know there are times everybody else, it's not often now, but everybody else is passing me by and I want to have the inkling, well, I'm tired of everybody passing me. But guess what? I should not be worried about them passing me on the highway. I should be more concerned, am I doing right by going the speed limit? Amen. And if they're in a hurry, I'll see them later. Go right on. Okay. It is just time for us to do the right thing. And I know everybody that you issue love to hands you back hate. But guess what? The Bible says if your brother gives you stone, you ought to still give him bread. Okay. So I know there are times you say, Pastor, that's because you're the preacher. Let me tell you something. Preachers are just men and women called by God to do a special work. That's all. We are called by God to do a special work. And that's why I tell preachers and I tell ministers and I tell pastors and I tell those whom God has called to minister his word, you better be sure that it is God who's called you, because you're no longer just responsible for yourself. And that's why it is so important when we say that we are children of God. And I know, Sister Hope, keep count, because I hope nobody, I don't lose anyone. That's why we've got to be so careful of what we flip-flop and put on social media. We've got to be so, because you cannot be so full of the Holy Ghost today and then you cussing somebody else out on Facebook the next day. It does not work like that. Let me tell you this. You've got to understand, you got to do the right thing regardless who else does not do the right thing. And I know sometimes people will say, that's weak. No, that's not being weak. That's just being meek, because that's what God requires of us. And everybody will not do right. Everybody will not say the right thing. Everybody will not do the just thing. But guess what? If you hold yourself accountable for that which you know is the right thing to do, God will show favor upon you. Okay? You've got to know when you're right. And then let me tell you something. Sometimes now, and it works so much better for me. When I know that what I've done stands pleasing in the sight of God, when I know that it's tangled up in the word of God, and I know that it has been the right thing to do, I'm able to sleep at night. I don't stand there and argue with folks. Because if you search the scripture, you search the scriptures, and if anybody can tell me where Jesus stood anywhere and argued with somebody, then you let me know. Because even when they were throwing the law at him, when the woman was caught in the act of adultery, the scripture says he bent down and he wrote in the ground. In other words, I'm ignoring them. I'm not condoning what you've done, ma'am. I'm not. But they're not any better than you who have messed up. It's just that you got caught. It may not have been the right thing to do, but what they're trying to do to you is not the right thing either. So we should not have the eye for an eye. Don't have that mentality, because God will handle the vengeance. God will take care of that. So that's the first thing that God says to us tonight. The Lord has says we know what is good. And the first thing that he says to us, he requires of us, is to do what is right. Do justly. And that's why you hear people that justice will prevail, because justice should be the right thing. Let me tell you something. The justice of God is the right thing. And that's why our ancestors, you would hear them pray in their prayer. If justice had called for satisfaction, we would have been cut off and gone. Yeah, my grandparents used to pray that prayer. That's because God's justice is the right justice. So that's why you just do the right thing according to what God has asked of you. And then the second thing he says is that we ought to love mercy. We ought to love mercy. Let me say this to you. As Holy Ghost filled as you are, as fire baptized as you may be, you may have the gift of prophecy, the gift to be able to speak in tongues. But let me tell you something. If you do not know, let me help you out tonight. It's because of God's grace and God's mercy that you're still standing, because we all have sinned and fallen short. But because of the mercies of God, and you know what? He wants us to love mercy, because he gives us new mercies each and every day. So if you love something, you will appreciate it. You will take care of it. And you make good use of it. We are to love mercy. Everyone that we meet will not love mercy. Everyone that we meet will not have the heart of compassion. But you and I, my brothers and my sisters, when we are called, baptized, adopted into the family of God, we are to love mercy, because we know if it had not been for mercy, we wouldn't be where we are. Because I don't know about anybody else on the call. I don't know about anybody else on the teleconference. I don't know about anybody else on Facebook, if other than me. Even when I try to do good, evil is always present. When I try to give my best, folks still find something that's wrong with it. But that's why you ought to love mercy, because guess what? If you think that you've never made a mistake, or if you've never done anything wrong, just keep on living. And some of us, do great work when we're asleep. Somebody will catch that a little bit later. Some of us, our best work are when we're asleep. Nobody on the lines, but some of our best work is when we're asleep. Why, Pastor? Because your mouth is shut. Your mouth is shut. And we've got to understand that we sin by thought, word, or deed. And so sometimes, if we're not careful, as someone said to me just yesterday, and that's why we've got to understand, pastors are not the only person who ministers to people. Pastors are not the only person who ministers to people. You are a disciple. You can minister to anybody who stands in need of a ministry, but you've got to make sure that you're equipped. Don't put yourself in a position that something can come, oh, God have mercy, Jesus, that something can leap into you now. But let me just say this to you. We ought to all have mercy. I love mercy because mercy keeps me going. The joy of the Lord is my strength, but guess what? I still fall short. I'm more than a conqueror, but guess what? I still fall short. I praise God with an extraordinary praise, but I still fall short. I help those who tried to condemn me, but I still fall short. I give my best when nobody else around me is even thinking about working, but I still mess up. And because I mess up, because I fall short, I love mercy. And they say mercy has a twin sister, grace. Grace and mercy carries us to the next level. He gives us new mercies every day. And don't you know that his grace is sufficient? I didn't make that up. That's the word. He gives us new mercies every day, and his grace is sufficient. So even when you feel down in the dumps, you know that in my weakest hour, God becomes to make me strong. Yes, he will. But you've got to learn to love mercy. Because let me tell you what happens when you love mercy. You will look beyond somebody else's fault, and you'll see their need, because you will say this, but by the grace of God goes me. And we'll be so careful how we beat up on other people's children and we condemn other people's children and we say all manner of evil about other people's children. Because but by the grace of God goes your child. And we've got to understand, we can pour into our children all that we want. But there comes a time in their lives that they're going to make decisions that you know what you taught them does not line up with it. But you love mercy enough that you say, Lord, hear my cry. Hear my call. Hold my child, Lord. Because your parents prayed for you when you thought you were indispensable. When you thought that you were on top of the world. Your parents was praying for you. When you were in the nightclubs ringing wet, come on somebody, don't act like you've always been in the church. When you were so drunk, you didn't know how your car got from point A to point B. God's mercy. And so how can you not love something that you're given every day? Not that you're worthy of it now. I want you to understand that. You don't deserve it. But God grants it to you. Nothing so good that you've done that you deserve God's mercy. But thanks to his son. Thanks to his son, Jesus, the Christ, sits on the right hand of his father, making an intercession for you and I. And so I say to you tonight, first thing you got to do the right thing. Do the right thing. And secondly, what does the Lord require of us? He requires us to love mercy. He gives us mercy. So why can't we give mercy to somebody else? God. Pastor, they're abusing me. That's why when you ask God to give you a spirit of discernment, God will give you the right words, so when they come back to abuse you, God will still allow you to be used. And he gets the glory. Preacher, you sure about that? Yes, because the man at the gate, he looked for a handout every day. And when those boys walked up, they said, look here now, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, I give it unto you. What is that thing? His name is Jesus. He's a mighty God. He's a wonder worker. And again, why, Pastor, should I love mercy so much? It's because you're given a new set each and every day. That's God's gift to us. New mercies. And then when mercy can't be extended, he said, my grace is sufficient. Okay, so first we have to do the right thing. I told you we weren't gonna be long tonight at all. I tell you gotta do the right thing. And then secondly, you've got to love mercy. And thirdly, to walk humbly with God. And I'm taking my time tonight, and trust me, I'm so excited. I want to get up out of this seat and just jump. But I want you to understand tonight, I want this to be taught so that when you walk away tonight, when wrongness slaps you in the face tomorrow, you're going to still be determined to do the right thing. And before you bring condemnation on somebody else, you're going to love mercy enough to say, Lord, if I can't help, don't let me stop them. And then thirdly, we got to walk humbly with God. We got to walk humbly. Let me tell you something. Y'all don't know anybody like this, but I know people like this, and maybe you might can find some in your world, but I know people like this. It's always, look what I've done. Oh man, if it wasn't for me, I was able to do this. I was able to do that. I got them straight. We even have people who like to say, I get the pastor straight. I don't know how they're able to do that, but you know. Leave it to me. I got this. Look at my house. Look at my car. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But the main thing you forgot is who gave it to you. The main thing you forgot is that he allowed you to be able to get a job, that you're able to get these things. And then if he brings you to a point where you're able to retire, he allows you to maintain these things. We forget about that. So we've got to learn to walk humbly. And let me tell you something. When you learn to walk humbly, it doesn't mean you let people walk over you. You're not a doormat. But you got to understand that you are just a child of God who is saved by God's grace. And that's humbling within itself, because we're all sinners now. And as I shared with you before, as a Christian, I'm just one beggar telling another beggar where we can find the man who has the bread. That's all it is. I'm one beggar trying to tell another beggar about the man who has the bread. And so we've got to understand, we have got to get ourselves, come off the high horse. Come off the high horse. Because that's why, Sister Doherty, because all glory belongs to God. So we've got to learn to walk humbly before him. We've got to learn. He does not want a coward soldier, but guess what? He doesn't want a bragging one either. Because when you, and that's why when people, and I try to get these young ministers to understand this, I try to get these young men and young men and young ladies who are coming up in the gospel, I try to get them, you don't preach what is popular. You preach what is right. Because once they have used you up, if you've not treated people right along the way, and if you have not walked humbly before God, God's going to say, you got your reward right then and there. But everything that we as humble children, we know that everything belongs to God. We know that our very being is because of God's existence and his hand on us. Hallelujah, Sister Jones. Hallelujah. We know we've got to learn to walk humbly. I was not, and I'll be very transparent, I was a child who was afraid. I was afraid of spanking. I'll just be honest. I was afraid of getting my behind cut. My sister Annie can tell you. Okay? Now, thank God, you know, my parents were up in ages. There was not too much spanking they could do. But my mama still could get that switch. Is there anybody other than me who they sent you for the switch? And then you couldn't have come back with one that wasn't the right size, Sister Lazarus. Because if you did, they'll send you back. Amen, amen. Somebody can relate to that. But I always did what was asked of me to the best of my ability. Now understand, I was no perfect child. Now, I'm not gonna sit here and tell you that bold-faced lie. But I made sure that I honored the mother and the father, that my days may be long upon the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. And that just didn't mean my mother and father. Anybody who could have been my mother or father, I gave them honor. I was an humble child. Any of my siblings can tell you that. Because I just felt that I was more blessed, more people could help me when I just remained humble. And as I learned more of the Lord, I realized that's why I have the favor of God. That's right. The favor of God will follow you when you walk humbly. Stop it, Sister Andre. You remember. Yes, you do. Shh, don't tell it all. All right. But what we've got to remember is that we have got to learn that when we remain humble, favor follows. And that foolishness about them saying, good evening, Brother Smalls, that foolishness they say my favor isn't fair, that's a lie. Favor is fair because if you have walked humbly before the Lord, if you have done that which God has asked of us to do, God will show you favor and you will turn around and wonder, Lord, I thank you. But we've got to learn, and I think if we want the gun violence, if we want the hypocrisy, if we want, I'm saying this, and I want us to understand, just not ours, but there are church doors now that are opening, and we're going to gradually open back into the. But let me say this to you: don't go back in the sanctuary with the same mentality. You've got to go back in the sanctuary doing what is right, walking and loving mercy. So when that person comes and that person sits 6 feet apart from you, or that person sits a distance from you, that person's not dressed like you, and that person doesn't smell like your perfume or your cologne, and that person just, you're not going to judge them, because guess what? Because of COVID, we were all put out. Get out. And so now that we're coming back, we have to remain humble. Because at the end of the day, God still has the final say-so. At the end of the day, God's still going to make that judgment call. at the end of the day. And I know what you're saying. I know what you're saying, Pastor. But it seems like the wrong is prevailing, and people who are doing wrong are not being punished. You are not going to know everything, because some people, they won't let you know the hell that they're going through. Come on, somebody. Some of us on this line tonight, we can say, if you only knew my story, if you had been through what I've been through, you would have lost your mind. But you learn to do the right thing. You learn to love mercy. And you learn to walk humbly, not before God, but with God. Because I don't know about you, but I can't even walk without him holding my hand. I can try my best to do this and my best to do that, but I can't, with God, I can do, without God, I can do nothing. I can't even control my breathing when I go to sleep. God has to do it. That's why I gotta walk humbly. I can get up and don't know I'm up. Ah, God, tonight. So when you and I have been spared and our lives have been changed, oh God, I'm getting excited. And God has done a new thing in our lives, and God has turned us around, and God has melted that cold, stony heart of ours, and God has put a vision in our minds, and God has placed our feet on a solid rock. If they're gonna talk, let them talk. I told somebody the other day, I said, Vice President Harris, I'm stealing her words. When I see folks coming up to me with foolishness, I'm going to say what she said this week. Don't come. I warned you. Don't come. Because we've got to learn to do the right thing. And if you're not going to do the right thing, don't come. And you've got to learn to love mercy. I know that it's God's mercy and God's grace that's keeping me right where I sit today. I know it's not a fake, not a fraud, not a show, not a performance. I know that God's grace and mercy has kept me. And that's why I love mercy so much. I love it. I love it. I love the mere fact that God shines his light from heaven on my soul. And so if you think that you're going to get me out of character, or if you're going to make me not love mercy the way that I do, don't come. And then you got to walk, put away. Pride is something we were taught to have. Mm-hmm. And we're losing that. We're losing that. Take pride in what you do. Take pride in the way you present yourself. But don't be so full of pride that God can't use you. Mm-hmm. I don't know if she's still on, but Sister Dorothy Simmons-Smalls, let me tell you something. I know the sales in Marshall have gone up on those hair bonnets. I know y'all selling them. I know you're selling them. They probably can't stay on the shelf. You know why? Because I see most of them in the stores. We ladies, now come on now. Come on. Have pride. Don't be full of pride, but take pride on yourself. Those things are given a name for a reason. Bedroom slippers. There's a bed in your car. is a bed in the schoolhouse? Pajamas. Are you going to bed when you show up at that school? Y'all don't get me. No, don't have Pastor go there. Not tonight. I'm coming back, Sister Hope. I'm coming back. But we've got to learn to walk humbly before God. And we have got to understand that we're not half the things we think we are. You know, we like to say this, we a bag of chips and all of that. Yeah, I'm blessed like that. But I will never forget where God has brought me from. I'll never forget that because of his mercy and his grace, I'm able to stand where I am. And when people, and I want you to do me a favor, I want you to make sure you find yourself a prayer partner. I want you to make sure you find yourself somebody in the midst of when you're going through, you can hold on to God's unchanging hand. Because let me tell you something, the day will come when the person you put the most trust in will leave by their own decision or by God's decision. But when you know that it is God that sustains you, and it's God that's keeping you, you remain humble. When you know that your life, your heart, the work that God has allowed you to establish over the years can be gone in a matter of minutes, tell God thank you. So that's all I want you to, I just want you to understand tonight. Micah 6 and 8. God, what are you asking of me? What do you require of me? That's right, Brother Stephen. The unjust will not prosper. They will not. Just like the weapons will be formed, but they aren't going to prosper. But you got to stay humble. Okay? And understand this now. Walking humble does not mean you're going to always have it Burger King's mentality. But if I stay humble through the storm, through the rain, through the fire, and through the pain, God has a plan. God has a plan. So understand that tonight. Just do the right thing. Love mercy. And all God, walk humbly with God. God wants to use so many of us. God wants to use so many of us. But we're so heavenly minded that we're no earthly good. That's right. We're so heavenly bound that we're no earthly good. But God has to take us through a process. It will not happen overnight. I'm not going to sit here. I'm not going to say to you that it's going to happen overnight, but I will say this to you. If you just continue to be faithful, if you continue to do what God says to do, God's going to bring you through. And Sister Lazarus, that's, I say that daily. I say that daily. God, use me, Lord, for your glory. Because guess what? I'm going to fade off the scene one way or the other. One way or the other. So, because only what I do for Christ is going to last. Only what I do for Christ is going to last. Only what I allow God to do in my life is going to make a difference. And you don't have to wait until you're dead and gone. What will be said about you when you leave the room? That's it. what will be said when you leave the room. And you can't fake this thing but so much. Because God will expose you. He will bring you to open shame. And just because everybody else is being mean to somebody, it does not make it right. Pastor, you don't know what they did to me. No, I don't. And guess what? And I say this with much respect. It really doesn't make a difference. Because like, I don't know what they've done to you. I don't know what you've done to them. But I do know that God has kept you for a purpose. I do know that God has kept you for a reason. I do know that God will keep you in perfect peace. I do know that God will give you a peace of mind. Oh, God, tonight up in this room, God will give you a peace of mind that will surpass us all understanding. But that's when you walk humbly. Brother Dupree, God will bless the business if you stay humble and thank him along the way. But we've got to learn to love mercy. Stop finding fault with everything. And when the complainers come to you, do as your vice president says. And yes, she's all about, if you live in these United States of America, whether you like it or not, she is your vice president. Don't come. It's time for the games to stop. We are getting ready to go back into a sanctuary. But I want the church to be right. I want the church to be able to walk back into the church with a renewed spirit, with a renewed commitment, with a new outlook on saying, but by the grace of God goes all of us in here, because we all could have been gone. Yes, I know what the statistics says about who died of COVID, but the statistics don't tell us how many people survived it. Oh, God, I thank you. Preacher, what is your problem? Why are you just concentrating so much on us doing the right thing and loving mercy and walking humbly with God? I'm going to tell you, you know why? Because when you look at me these days, I want you to understand something. This ain't no ordinary song, yeah. There's nothing ordinary anymore.
The God himself is greater than.
And because he's no ordinary God, I got more than just an ordinary praise.
This ain't no ordinary
words. It's time for the ordinary to be done away with. It's time for us to do right. It's time for us to love mercy. And it's time for us to walk humbly before the Lord, with the Lord. I have not come this far in my life to let anybody distract me from the vision. Oh, God. Woo! That's it. Do the right thing. Woo. And if nobody else prays him, you praise him. Because you know what he's done for you, in spite of you. God, I thank you tonight. Ain't no ordinary worship. This ain't no ordinary song. y'all realize what God is doing in our lives right now? Do you realize how God is sweeping us up and holding us like an infant? Do you realize the miraculous thing that God is doing with you in spite of you? Ooh. Ooh. It ain't on. Let me tell you something. No, I'm not ordinary anymore, because God has done an extraordinary thing with a little old country boy. And that's why I'm going to do right. If I'm the only one doing right, do it. If I'm the only one who's going to love mercy, I'm going to love it by myself. And if I'm the only one who's going to walk humbly with God, I'll do it by myself. And if you don't plan to do it, don't come. If you don't want to do it, don't come. Yeah, I know I scared some of you when I had it, but I had to get your attention. This ain't no ordinary stuff anymore. You can't go back to the same old, same old. We can't do that. We can't do that. We can't do that. We can't do that. The season for that is over. How many of you willing to join me tonight as I close? How many of you willing to say, Pastor, I'm going to do the right thing. I'm going to give it my best shot, Pastor. I might stumble and fall, but I'm going to do my best to do the right thing. And I'm going to love mercy. And right now I'm going to ask God to let me walk humbly with him. It's part of our problem. We all want to walk before God. But how can you go before the man who has the plan? How can you go before the man who made you? Don't come. That's right, new creatures. New creatures. Maybe you're not there yet. Maybe you're not there yet. Maybe you're still working on it. But I want you to know tonight that God is able. Sister Hope, if you're still on the line, if you're still with me, I see you're still with me, go ahead and put our teleconference number. Put our teleconference number up for them. And the access code. And we invite you, starting this Friday morning at 6 o'clock. Thank you, God, for the ones who are saying, I'm going to do... Ooh, God, I thank you. God, I praise you tonight. God, I praise you tonight. God, I worship you tonight.
Because all I seem to do is hurt me.
God, I thank you. God, I praise your holy name. God, I thank you in advance. God, I thank you in advance. We invite you this Friday morning as we begin our 10-day journey back to the sanctuary. For the next 10 days, starting Friday, this Friday morning, June the 11th, at 6 o'clock a.m., we're going to be in prayer every morning for the next 10 mornings from June the 11th until Sunday, June the 20th. Every morning. We're going to be petitioning the Almighty God. Too much gun violence. Too much hypocrisy. Too much throwing bricks and hiding hand. Too much arguing over little stuff. Too much of the pity parties. It's time to say, Lord, I've decided to press my way. We're going to touch and agree. And I don't know about anywhere else, but 378 Mathis Ferry Road in Mount Pleasant, South Carolina, we will not be the same come June 20th. We will not walk back into that building the way we came out of that building. Because God has done so much with us, to us, and through us, that we are to what? Do the right thing. Love mercy and walk humbly before God. That's all Micah 6 and 8 says. What does the Lord require of us? He says it. And if you don't intend to do those three things with me, don't come. We're going to pray. We're going to pray tonight. We're going to lift up those who are in prayer tonight. Pray again for the Holy Trinity family. As God has called one of our faithful servants on from labor to reward. That's what we're living for. I didn't understand it then, Mama, but Mama would say, live right so you can die right. I didn't understand it then, but I understand it now. Love mercy, because that's what gets you up every day. New set of mercies. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, the creator of all good and perfect gift. God, we thank you for being who you are. We thank you for loving us the way that you've loved us. We thank you for how you have brought us in the midst of all that you have brought us through. We thank you for loving us in spite of who we are. We thank you for hearing our cry in the middle of the night. Thank you for answering our prayers. God, look at those who are sick. God, I lift up the Alston family. I lift up one, Helen Brown, to you right now, God. Ease the pain on her body. And Father God, we just ask that you touch those who I do not know by name, but God, you know where they are. And even though our names may not appear on somebody's sick and shut-in list, God, we still tell you thank you. Because God, we know that you're blessing. And Lord, I just ask that that which I poured out tonight has been pleasing in your sight. And that someone will leave here a little stronger than they came. Bless us because we want to be blessed. Keep us because we need to be kept. Melvin Rouse, he knows your name. He knows what you need. He knows how much of it you need. And may the grace of God, the sweet communion of his Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide with us now, henceforth, and forevermore. I want you to know three things tonight. Know that you're blessed. Know that you're a valued vessel. And know that you're loved. Lady Holmes and I love you. We thank you for joining us tonight. We thank you for allowing God to come into the room, the teleconference and Facebook. If you want to be a blessing to this ministry, our Cash App is listed. Cash App so that you may be a blessing to this ministry because God is doing great things. Then scroll down in the line and get that number Friday morning starting at 6 o'clock. And we'll be for every morning for the next 10 days. You're invited to join. All you need to do is have a praying spirit and watch God do the work. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you. And please know that I love you. God bless you. Have a wonderful evening. And may the peace of God be with you. Patricia Lilly, I see you out there. I see you out there, Patricia Lilly. Just giving God praise. Thank you. God bless you.
So now I pour out my heart to you.
I just need some people to pause. Just put some hearts up. Just put some hearts up and let me know you're praising him with me. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, God, I thank you tonight. Thank you, Brother Dwayne and Sister Dorothy, for joining us. Thank you, Sister Kelly. God bless you. Oh, God, I thank you. God, I thank you tonight. Oh, God. Sister Georgetta is working out right now. Woo!
I pour out my heart.
Sister Demetrius, don't get angry.
Give me my heart.
Hallelujah. Woo! They don't understand it. Woo! God, I thank you. Y'all know I'm not ready to go.
I am ready.
And I'm gonna go. And may the blessings of God be with each of you. Love you. Stay faithful and stay humble. Sister Raven, God bless you. Reverend Parker, thank you. And we'll look forward to seeing you in the next few days. God bless you. Oh, God, I thank you. Oh, God, I thank you. Ooh. Oh, how you talk with me.
Oh, how you talk with me.
God bless you.